I'm going to do, and I'm going to let Mike do most of the talking, so hang on, but I'm just, he knows where we're going with this. First thing I'm going to do, I'm going to play a one-minute clip of Dr. Jerome Corsi, the author of Where's the Birth Certificate. He was on the air last night, or two nights ago, I think, on Hannity, on Fox News. And it's a one-minute clip of Hannity talking to Dr. Corsi. And with that conversation, you'll hear the conversation. I'll let Mike analyze it for you. But it went all over the internet that Dr. Corsi basically trashed the birth certificate issue. That's not the case, but Mike Zullo can explain that for you. And then right after that, I'll come back and introduce the NBC clip, and I'll tell you more about that in a moment. And that's going to chap your hide if you've been following this case very long. So, Mallory, if you play that first clip, Mike, you stand by. As soon as we come back, Mike, I'm going to let you analyze it.
I'm reading what the media writes about you, that you didn't believe the moon landing was real, or that 9/11, I want to get it accurate, was an inside job. I don't know if you believe those things or not. Do you? Because I was surprised
no,
when
I
read it.
That's all fabrication. I don't believe it. But you're getting to a very important point. Aaron Zelinsky, one of the prosecutors, ridiculed me. He said, you just take this fact, that fact, you make lies. Well, I know he's ridiculing my work on, you know, Barack Obama, the birth certificate. He's ridiculing the swift boats. I'm being persecuted and prosecuted because the left wants to get rid of me.
And they want to ridicule these books. You're allowed to have controversial opinions and views. I would disagree with you on both of those things, but this isn't what's at issue here. What's at issue here is, were you offered basically freedom if you told lies? And you're saying they wanted you to lie, they were pushing you to lie.
Yes, after the first grand jury testimony, they all shook my hand and congratulated me.
Okay, all right, fantastic. So Mike Zullo, I'm going to let you analyze it, but I've got to say this, it's killing me. I never really realized how much Hannity panicked and cut him off as soon as he mentioned the birth certificate. Just cut him off and then made it clear. Well, I disagree with you on both of those counts. I'm sorry. I had to say that, Mike. I hope I didn't steal your thunder, but it just hit me as I was listening to this for the 15th time. Go ahead, Mike.
Third rail in politics and the third rail in the media. It's like you go anywhere near it and you get fried, and that's exactly what they were doing to Jerry Corsi. You know, in the context of that interview, which I saw live on Hannity, I was actually taken back by his answer. And until I listened to it again, and then I actually called Jerry to find out what was going on, and I explained to him that I had heard it, and it sounded like he was disavowing his position on the birth certificate issue and a number of other things. And he goes, oh, where did you get that? I said, well, if you listen to what you said, he goes, Mike, he wrapped everything in one question, and I was talking about them trying to say that I'm a liar or telling me what I believe.
Yeah.
And he made this point. He said, if you go back and look at my work over 20 years, he goes, what I do is I go on a fact-finding mission on a narrative that's been laid out, and I look for inconsistent facts.
Yes.
Or things to bolster an alternative argument, and that's what I write about.
Yes.
Now, what are my beliefs and what aren't my beliefs? That's for me to know, but that's not included in my writing. I'm trying to be provocative. And he also went on to tell me, he goes, Mike, you know where I stand on that birth certificate. That's not a birth certificate. So he drew my attention then to the second clip that you're going to play, which was the NBC interview, which I hadn't heard.
Right.
And when your audience hears this, I think they're going to get the picture.
Oh, yeah. You're going to like that. And I appreciate the fact that you said you saw that first clip with Hannity. You saw that interview live. And even watching it live, even with your sharp and investigative mind, you were just a little bit unclear as to exactly where Corsi went with that. And you and I both agree that it really wasn't Corsi's fault. It just points out what you said, the need to be very clear when you're doing media, because they will chop and edit and cut you off and won't let you complete a sentence. And by the time you're finished, it makes you sound like you said something you didn't say.
Well, and Carl, they also want to discredit him on this issue.
Of course.
Like they wanted to do you and I or anyone else that's on the opposite side of the equation.
Yes.
That's the game.
Yeah,
and that's what they tried to rope him into.
Yeah, no, you're right. And not only discredit us, but they don't want to get engaged in a technical conversation with us. Even me. I mean, you're the investigator. They surely don't want to do it with you. But since I'm kind of the mouthpiece and have been for years, and I know a lot of what you know, not everything, but they don't want to get engaged with me, little old me, in the technical aspects. They just cut you down. Well, I don't believe it. That's a conspiracy theory. Let's move on. And it's just, it's unbelievable. Then sticking their fingers in their ears and their hands over their eyes going, nanny, I don't see anything. I don't hear anything. Oh, my gosh.
Well, you know, to your point, Carl, right after you play the second clip, I'm going to explain to you why they don't want to engage us. Because I don't think your audience understands. I don't think the general public understands what was really accomplished in this investigation.
Yeah.
And when I lay it out, I think it's going to be clear as to why no one wants to challenge it.
Okay, good. Folks, listen, we're going to play the second clip. Let me set it up. It's an NBC clip, an interview, I think, Monday night. There is a woman interviewing Dr. Corsi. I'm so sorry. I don't know her name. She's an NBC host. And you're going to hear it. It's a one-minute clip. It's in context. And it's basically everything that they talked about on the birth certificate. It was about 1 minute long. But listen to how she sets him up. She's so snarky. She's so accusatory. And she sets him up and basically calls him a liar. Well, you lie about everything, so. And then he eventually talks about the birth certificate. You'll hear that. And then listen to how she does, just like Hannity. When it starts getting to the facts, she panics and shuts it down. She doesn't want to go there. Mallory, go ahead and play it.
You have made up stories that have been untrue in the past, like the birther.
Oh, see, that's Aaron Zelinsky. Aaron Zelinsky says, Dr. Corsi, you're very good at picking these facts and doing a narrative which is lying, where we have a world in truth and falsity. I said, well, Mr. Zelinsky, I knew he was talking about the birth certificate. I'll defy you to show me Barack Obama's 1961 original Hawaiian birth certificate.
Do you still believe that Barack Obama was not born in the United States?
Well, I believe there's no birth certificate from 1961. I was out
there. He did release a birth certificate.
It was a computer printout, which didn't exist in 1961. And the forensic analysis that Sheriff Arpaio did on it said it was a fake.
It does seem that you just can't help yourself with a juicy conspiracy.
I see. Now, that goes back to the CIA, and anybody who doesn't believe Lee Harvey Oswald pulled the trigger and killed JFK is a nutcase. Because you're now locked into, you may not realize it, but you're locked into official government explanations of events they don't want examined.
All right. Well, let's put that aside and let's keep going.
Okay, Mike, I want you to have all the time you can. I'm sitting here, smoke is coming out of my ears. What a snarky little reporter that was. Go ahead, Mike, you talk.
Well, Carl, I mean, that explanation was just stellar.
Yes.
He burned her house down with that explanation.
Yes.
And if you notice what she's doing, she is trying to paint him as some kind of lunatic, a liar,
yep.
Someone who can't help himself,
yep.
As if there's something wrong with him.
Yep.
And then he goes right out and he says, right to her face, I'm not talking about where he was born. I'm telling you, there is no real birth certificate.
Right.
And he knows that because he went there trying to get it himself.
Right.
And he couldn't ascertain any information regarding a birth certificate. So she comes back and she says what she says. And what does he do? He points right out to her and says, now you're hearing to government explanations.
Yes.
In other words, the narrative.
Yes. And basically, he said to her, you can't help yourself. You're being brainwashed by the government. You believe anything they tell you. And we're sitting on a 5-year criminal investigation saying the government's lying. And you won't even let us talk about the details. You can't help yourself, girl.
Exactly. And that's what the public is just been conditioned to do. Take
yes.
the 30-second explanation because it sounds plausible.
Yeah.
Well, and that's going to go into the next point. Carl, I don't know if I can hear music. How much longer do we have?
Okay, let's do this. It is time for a soft break, Mike. So we're going to take it, and then we're going to go right to the next point. People are hanging on with bated breath, plus you have some revelation to give us. So, folks, you are listening to Freedom Friday with Carl Gallup. You're in the Oval Office of Gulf Coast Talk Radio. Mike Zullo is my guest, and this is why you're listening. Mallory Bardwell, my world-famous producer, is in the house. Right, and we're glad that you didn't change the dial. We know that you're back, and we thank you for that. Oval Office, Gulf Coast Talk Radio. We're right here. We're broadcasting live this Friday afternoon, 1330 AM, 99.1 FM talk radio right here on the Gulf Coast. Mike Zullo is my guest. So, Mike, I want to turn it over to you. I'm here if you need me, but otherwise, talk to the audience that goes worldwide, and tell him what's on your mind. Now, you and I talked offline. I know where you're going to go. This is amazing. Go ahead.
Well, Carl, what I think the public doesn't understand is when we first initially interacted with Jerry Corsi in his birth certificate investigation and some others, they brought information to us. And based on that information, it was pretty clear to us from what's called a probable cause standard in law enforcement. And probable cause, if you remember, we said this, we believe there's probable cause that the document is fictitious. We said it in both press conferences.
Right.
Probable cause standard is the sufficient reason based upon known facts to believe a crime has been committed or that certain property is connected with a crime. So we've got a phony birth certificate based on the evidence presented to us. We know it's not a real birth certificate. We know it's been proffered. And that's how we got to the probable cause standard. Now, initially, we just wanted to hand this off to federal authorities, but we've already discussed that ad nauseum, why that couldn't have happened.
Yeah, deep state, Obama.
But your audience may remember some years back, I had said that I had a meeting with Sheriff Arpaio after that second press conference, and I said, you know, there's another way out at this. There's something really wrong with the document, and he gave me the authority to continue. And then, you remember, I went dark for
yes.
various reasons.
Yes.
During that time, what was done is this was escalated way beyond probable cause through investigation.
Yep.
And one thing your audience really has to now understand and be clear on, just because something is evidence doesn't mean your theory is actually true. And let me explain that. Evidence is the availability of a body of facts or information indicating whether a belief or proposition is true or valid. So evidence just on itself, and to give you an example, you may have a bloody nose. There's evidence that you have been punched in the nose. However, if you accuse me of punching you in the nose, there's no evidence that I was there punching you in the nose, causing the damage. Now, somebody produces evidence of a videotape, that changes the evidentiary standard, and that moves into what's called proof. There's a difference. Proof is a higher standard than probable cause, and if you go into criminal law, you have to come to a proof beyond reasonable doubt conclusion. So proof is the cogency of evidence that compels acceptance by the mind of a truth or a fact. Mm-hmm. And cogency is the operative word here because cogency means the quality of being clear, logical, and convincing. And in the last press conference, I believe it was, we actually had said that we believe we hit the threshold of proof beyond reasonable doubt.
That's right. That was December 2016.
If you look at what was accomplished by the last press conference, we had forensic examinations, scientific fact. We have proved 5, 6, 7 different times over that the document was fabricated, that we have or we are in possession of one of the documents that we used that we believe was utilized in the fabrication of the phony PDF. And all of this is resting on the one irrefutable fact that a PDF file is not an authentic birth certificate.
Exactly.
The public has never seen it. This is why it's imperative for the other side of this argument to try to discredit the messengers.
Right.
Try to discredit anyone taking the other side, because had this document been thoroughly investigated by federal authorities, they would have come to that conclusion and beyond. And if this document was ever adjudicated in a court of law, it would have been deemed a fabrication.
Right. And you and I have begged authorities. In fact, let me do it again, because I know the deep state listens. I know other media listens to us. We're heard all over the world, and we're posted all over the internet. So let me challenge the fake news. Now you have a chance to come clean. Here's your challenge. Mike Zullo and I and Sheriff Arpaio and others that are involved in this, the digital document examination entities, none of us are trying to to impugn someone who's innocent. We have no desire to do that, even if we disagree with one Barack Obama's politics, which I do. All we want is the truth. We have the science. What, you don't like science? Mallory Bardwell said that. I wish I could say that. I wish she said, you know what, they don't like science? What is it? We have the science. We have the facts. We have the criminal investigation. And so all that Mike and I are saying is prove us wrong, forensically, with science, in a bona fide judicial type hearing, whether it's congressional or a court or whatever, or a federal law enforcement agency, prove us wrong. The point is, Mike, not only have they not, but they haven't even attempted, and we know that's because you know that they cannot, but they haven't even reported on the facts of what we have that you've reported, and there's so much more that you haven't even told them. They're scared to death of it because they know you're right, Mike. Go ahead.
Well, Carl, and, you know, it all boils down to this one question. Is that a valid birth certificate? And the answer is
no.
And they can't escape that fact.
Yeah, and the other fact they can't escape is no one outside of the Department of Health, if a true paper birth certificate exists with the seal of Hawaii on it, if that exists, no one outside of the Department of Health of Hawaii has ever presented that into the hands of reporters or law enforcement officials or Congress, and then accompanied by an affidavit with somebody putting their life on the line saying, I swear this is the real thing. It is certified. I'm signing this under the risk of going to prison. No one has done that. No one will do it.
No. And Carl, there is never going to be anyone that could attest to the validity of a PDF file as being a vital statistic document, that you just simply can't.
You can't. Not a soul listening to us, including the deep state, can take a PDF of their birth certificate. You can't buy a piece of bubble gum with it, much less get a driver's license, much less become the commander-in-chief of the world's most powerful military. You can't do it.
So the public, Carl, the public has never seen an authentic Hawaii birth certificate for Barack Obama. Even though they want to say there's information in the file, that doesn't make that the birth certificate.
Right.
And then there's big questions. You know, questions beget questions.
Yeah.
Then there's questions of when was this information entered into the file, by what means?
Yeah.
Because there is no original certificate.
Right, right.
There never was.
Exactly. Mike, listen, there's some more we need to talk about. Mike Shoesmith just emailed me and said, please give Mike Zullo more time if he needs it. Can you stay for at least one more 15-minute segment as we go to the bottom of the hour? You can do that? Okay.
Yes.
Because we
yes.
want to get back to Jerry Corsi, because I want you to make sure that our audience understands what's going on with the Mueller investigation and that Jerry Corsi is now refusing to sign the plea deal at the risk of going to prison. But you've talked to Jerry Corsi today, and you've got some scoop on all of that, and I think our audience needs to hear that today.
Okay, cool.
Okay, good deal. Well, folks, you know where you are. You're in the Oval Office of Gulf Coast Talk Radio, Freedom Friday with Carl Gallup's Mallory Bardwell, my world-famous producer. My guest this afternoon, the ever-popular guest on Freedom Friday, Mike Zullo. Mike Zullo, the lead investigator in the Obama fraud case under Sheriff Joe Arpaio when he was the sheriff of Maricopa County Sheriff's Office, the fourth largest sheriff's office in the nation, a five-year scientific criminal forensic investigation signed off on by affidavits of two international forensic document examiners. We've got the stuff, but the news won't talk about it. Hannity won't talk about it. NBC won't talk about it. Congress won't examine it. The three-letter agencies won't look at it. They just close their eyes and pretend like it doesn't exist. We'll be back after this timeout. Mike Zullo is going to stay on for a few more minutes. And Mike Zullo, welcome back as well. So, Mike, I'm going to ask you, tell us what you give us your opinions on the Jerry Corsi Mueller situation, and then tell us what you know based upon your personal conversations with Jerry Corsi. And then if we got a moment, you and I talked about doing something else as well. But you go ahead.
Well Carl, look, Jerry was subpoenaed by Mueller to come in and basically tell them whatever it is that they were looking, to garner from him. Apparently what they are trying to do is put a connection between Jerry Corsi and Julian Assange of WikiLeaks and Roger Stone, trying then to direct link that to the President of the United States. And I think Jerry was grilled by the special counsel's office for about 40 hours. Keep in mind, he's 72 years old.
Uh-huh.
And then they were asking him questions about emails that he and correspondence that he would have sent, you know, going back 2 years. And some things he just didn't remember right. or inaccurately recalled.
Right. I wouldn't either. Well, I don't know anybody that would.
And what had happened is the first half of their interrogation with him, which he fully cooperated, he actually turned over his computer system, and there's another device that archives all of his computer activities. I think it's called a time machine or something that he had, because they tried to make an accusation against him that he was deleting emails. And he clearly points out, I do that on a regular basis to keep my computer running, but this time machine archives everything.
Yeah.
And he gave that to them. Make a long story short, he was not able to provide the special counsel with the explanation that they wanted to fulfill their mission to link this to Stone and link it to the President of the United States, because right. he doesn't have any contacts with Julian Assange.
Right.
And what they did is what they did to everybody else. They tried to take inconsistent statements he made based on some two-year-old emails, that he even amended his testimony when he found out about the emails, that he had written some things or said some things, and they tried to accuse him of lying. It's the perjury trap.
Right.
All they have to do is say, we have contradictory evidence that contradicts what you just said to us, therefore you're lying.
Right.
Lying to investigators is a felony, and you'll go to jail for 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 years.
And they basically did that, and then offered him a plea deal wherein he had to sign that he had been lying.
Well, not only sign that he'd been lying, but in a plea deal, there's verbiage in there that tries to implicate the President of the United States.
Yeah.
And it's absolutely false.
Yeah.
And he would not do it. And he made the decision that he's not going to enter into a plea deal. If they want to indict him, go ahead. But he decided to make it public.
Right.
And where he is with this now, he's been probably the only person on the forefront to basically take the clothes off the emperor and expose the tactics that Mueller is doing.
Yeah.
And those tactics, they are meant to flip high-profile witnesses like cartel members and murderers and syndicate hitmen and things like that. Not an average citizen. Those tactics that they are using, I believe, is desperation, because they don't have any
That's
evidence
right.
to support the predicate charge that there was collusion or conspiring with the Trump campaign.
Right. So where's Jerry with
Jerry,
all of this?
Jerry, of course, he finds himself now in a position where he could be indicted any time, any day, arrested and incarcerated, and he's not going to take that laying down. My understanding in speaking with him, he has hired an attorney by the name of David Gray,
okay.
and an attorney familiar to your audience, Larry Klain.
Right, and you've got permission from Jerry to share all of this.
Yes, yeah. He gave me full authority to
right.
discuss this. My understanding is on Monday, Jerry Corsi last week said that he was going to file a criminal complaint against Mueller.
Right.
My understanding is on Monday that is going to happen, and the complaint is going to be released to the public. And this is his words. He told me, he said, Mike, he goes, these lawyers have come up with crimes I had no idea were even crimes
right.
that they have committed.
Right.
He goes, this thing is, it's the bomb.
Good.
So we're going to all sit with bated breath and yeah. see what this is, because these tactics and what they are doing, the coercion placed on people to lie, trying desperately to implicate the president on some level. Because, Carl, how do you justify $36 million of expense
right.
on this investigation? $36 million.
I know. Mike, what we are watching, we this is an example right before our eyes for 2 years of how the deep state and the leftists were working, and are still working. And this is one of their biggest displays right before our eyes. Because the bottom line is, Mike, you'll remember you were on Freedom Friday with me right after the president won and right when Mueller was put as special counsel and right when the initial allegations were coming out that he had colluded with Russia to literally jiggy-jaggy the election so that he would win by false pretenses with Russian help. That's what was charged. And you and I said, and I can't quote us, but we both said, Mike Shoesmith has said it, Brandon Big B has said it, I've said it multiple times, you've said it way back then, that if they were to find that Donald Trump, as much as I like him and supported him and endorsed him, if he truly did collude with the Russians and totally perverted our election system and he's a false president under false jiggy-jagging of the election system, then I would want something done with it. That's the difference between true conservatives and America-loving people and the socialists. The socialists lie. They make it up. Mueller apparently is lying. Of course he says he's lying. They're using horrible tactics against U.S. citizens to fabricate something. Gee, have they ever fabricated a birth certificate? I don't know. But they're fabricating this when you and I are saying all we want's the truth. We want the truth about the birth certificate. We want the truth about Trump. But now, 2 years later, we know that they have nothing on Trump, and 5 years later, we know the birth certificate's a lie, but nobody will hear the facts of either one of them yet.
Well, Carl, you know, these communist socialist types, the other tactic that they use is they accuse you of the very criminal activity that they themselves are doing.
Yes.
And they have the media in their pocket, so they're able to put it out there as if they have the moral superiority. They are beyond reproach. And they are calling you out when, in fact, it's them.
Yes.
There is so much evidence out there about Hillary Ron Clinton's campaign colluding to get that dirty dossier on Donald Trump, going out to foreign countries. So just the way information was obtained was utilized through three-letter agencies of other nations and then filtered back to the United States.
Yeah.
So their fingerprints weren't on collecting the dirt that they were trying to collect. Their fingerprints are on just receiving the information.
Yeah.
So it doesn't look like they were actually the ones perpetrating the acquisition.
Right.
I mean, this thing is stinks on all levels. And when you really get deep, and we don't have time, when you get deep into who all these players are and the things they have all done in the past, they are covering their own sins.
Yep.
And this, their own tracks.
And this is the...
That's why they are deathly afraid of Donald Trump.
Yes.
And Trump, I'm going to tell you, he's got something because he is starting to go out there and start tweeting that he's going to drop a load of information.
Yeah.
That would startle America.
I saw it.
The guy doesn't say anything for the sake of saying it.
No, he never does. And he tweeted a meme with pictures of Barack Obama, Hillary Clinton, Mueller, Comey, and others behind bars. The president tweeted a meme of these big, powerful deep state leaders behind bars. He called it treasonous, and he said, when are the trials going to begin? A U.S. president said that. Now, brother, that is huge. If I, as a radio host, did that on Facebook, that's one thing. For the president to do that, he's telegraphing, Mike.
Oh, he's definitely telegraphing. And go to Lindsey Graham in the Kavanaugh hearings. When he asked him about treason, he asked him, would that be adjudicated in a federal court or military tribunal? And the answer was military tribunal.
Right. This is unbelievable. Mike, in just the last few minutes, you and I were talking offline, and we were talking about the fact that, you know, they so desperately want Trump's tax returns. Tax returns. We want the tax returns. What if Donald Trump said, okay, I'm going to post it on the White House website. It's a PDF of my tax returns in multiple layers with other people's information embedded into my information. I wonder if they would have a criminal investigation.
Why not? Because the tax return, you know what? You can do that. Why not?
Yeah.
Why not just post his tax return saying, I didn't make any money, put it out there, and let them go at it.
Yeah.
Let them go at it. Because however they try to disprove it, It would be disproving that birth certificate in the same breath.
So, Mr. President, I don't know if you're listening today. You did allow me to open one of your rallies in Pensacola back in 2016 in January, and I appreciate that. About 20,000 people there, 12, 13, 14,000 inside, and 5, 6, 7, 7,000 outside, and I'm honored. So, Mr. President, if you're listening or if this clip gets back to you, I recommend you release your tax returns in PDF format. I just wanted to say that. Mike, listen, I'm going to give you the last 2 minutes. You say whatever you want to say. And hey, let's play that clip again. Can you do clip number two? It's a 1 minute clip. Folks, listen to this. And then, Mike, I'll let you comment it before we leave. Okay.
Okay.
All right.
You have made up stories that have been untrue in the past, like the birther.
Oh, see, this is Aaron Zelinsky. Aaron Zelinsky is Dr. Corsi. You're very good at picking these facts and doing a narrative which is lying, where we have a world in truth and falsity. I said, well, Mr. Zelinsky, I knew he was talking about the birth certificate. I'll defy you to show me Barack Obama's 1961 original Hawaiian birth certificate.
Do you still believe that Barack Obama was not born in the United States?
Well, I believe there's no birth certificate from 1961. I was out there.
He did release a birth certificate.
It was a computer printout, which didn't exist in 1961. And the forensic analysis that Sheriff Arpaio did on it said it was a fake.
It does seem that you just can't help yourself with a juicy conspiracy.
See, now that goes back to the CIA, and anybody who doesn't believe Lee Harvey Oswald pulled the trigger and killed JFK is a nutcase. Because you're now locked into, you may not realize it, but you're locked into official government explanations of events they don't want examined.
All right. Well, let's put that aside and let's keep going. So,
let's put that aside. Let's keep going. You don't confuse me with the facts. Mike Zullo, you take it.
Well, and Carl, if you notice what she did, they go right to his place of birth, birtherism.
Yeah.
Well, let me tell you something about our investigation. We have said this from day one. We don't care where he was born, that it was never in our purview. That is not something we were looking at. We were looking at the falsification of an official government document, a birth certificate.
Yes, that's good.
They can't parse these. Yep. They have to throw it all into where he was born. Well, look, let's let the truth be told. If the birth certificate isn't real, you don't know where he was born.
That's right.
That's
the fact.
Bottom line.
That's the
Nobody
fact.
Nobody knows.
That's right.
And
all they have to do is produce a paper certificate with a seal on it and an affidavit from somebody who's willing to go to prison if it's proven to be a lie. But they won't do it because they can't do it. Mike, we got to get out of here. I'll let you say whatever you want to say, and then we've got to go.
Carl, what we want to see was the original microfilm records from 1961, and we also would want to see the other file that contained information that was imported into, quote, the original file.
Yeah.
And I've explained that ad nauseum on your show.
You have.
The microfilm. The microfilm will have the truth.
Yep. Folks, please listen. We're going to take this time out. Mike Shoesmith will be coming up. But listen, those of you out here listening to us, get this clip today. Put it all over the internet. Put it all over social media. People have to hear what Mike Zullo has said and what the two of us have been talking about. This is important. Get it to the media. Get it to your representatives. Get it to anybody who can make a difference, because this has to be heard. I've got a feeling that something in the White House is fixing to pop on this very soon. We'll be back after this time out. Don't go anywhere. Give us 2 minutes.
For thousands of years, mankind has debated how creation began. Ancient texts tell us the story. But today, the real message behind the pivotal account of the Garden of Eden has been obfuscated and lost. That is, until now. World-renowned author Carl Gallups digs up the hidden truths from the book of Genesis to finally give back the knowledge that was lost to the world. Find out what really happened in the Garden of Eden, what Jesus taught about Eden on the cross, and how the conflict between Jesus and the gods of antiquity is about to erupt on planet Earth, fulfilling biblical prophecy. In the new book, Gods of Ground Zero, this explains everything.